Hi, my name is Anne. Welcome to the YouTube channel of MACHEREY-NAGEL. Today I want to show you how to perform the NANOCOLOR COD tube tests using the NANOCOLOR COD 1500 test kit. To perform the NANOCOLOR COD 1500 test kit, you need the test kit itself, which is sufficient for 20 determinations. A 2 mL piston pipette, suitable pipette tips, a safety bottle for shaking the tubes, a MACHEREY-NAGEL heating block, and a photometer. In our case, our spectrophotometer NANOCOLOR Advance, which is perfectly suited for mobile and laboratory water analysis. All NANOCOLOR test kits are labeled with the parameter, in our case the COD, the test number, the measuring range, the batch, and the expiry date. You can find the pictogram instructions in the lid of the box. The test contains 20 test tubes for the determination. Swirl the cuvette to bring the sediment into solution. Open the test tube and hold it in a 45-degree angle. Carefully add 2 mL of the sample. Place the test tube into the safety bottle. Shake the test tube thoroughly. Be careful, the vial gets very hot during mixing. Program the heating block on 148 degrees Celsius for 120 minutes. Place the test tube into the heating block and start the decomposition. You can also use the quick COD method at 160 degrees Celsius in 30 minutes. Please make sure that this method is sufficient for your sample by comparing the result to a normal decomposition at 148 degrees Celsius in 2 hours. After the heating process, take out the hot test tube, place it into a cuvette holder, and wait for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, take the cuvette, which is still warm, and shake it gently to get a homogeneous mixture without condensation. It is sufficient to just shake it only once. Place the COD test tube back into the cuvette holder and let it cool down to room temperature. Clean the test tube thoroughly. Be careful not to shake the test tube while cleaning. Check the test tube for turbidities. The tests are sensitive to turbidities. Make sure to have our NTU check always activated to prevent wrong results because of turbidity. Insert the test tube into the cuvette slot. The NANOCOLOR Advance recognizes the test number automatically and determines the result. It is shown on the display. A typical interference is chloride. Chloride ions interfere with COD measurements. The different kits tolerate different levels of chloride. Detailed information about chloride tolerance can be found in the instruction for use. Chloride levels above the tolerated level lead to a heavy turbidity. Depending on the test kit, this leads to false to high and false to low results respectively. In doubt of chloride concentrations, Quantafix chloride test strips can be used to quickly check the concentration. The chloride concentration can be lowered by dilution or by the use of our nanocolor chloride elimination cartridges. In case of high chloride sample, you can also use the nanocolor COD60 for salt water, which can tolerate up to 18 grams per liter chloride. If you encounter turbidity during the measurement, the NTU check will warn you. This result cannot be trusted. If the turbidity is not settled properly, it is helpful to place the cuvette in the still hot heating block for 1 minute. The turbidity will settle much faster in warm solutions. A common source of error is improper homogenization of the sample. Samples for COD measurements often contain large amounts of particles, especially in the inflow. These can lead to fluctuating measurement values. Make sure to homogenize the sample properly. This can be done by a magnetic stirrer. If you have larger particles in the sample, you can use a high-performance disperser. All important information can be also found in the instructions for use, the pictogram, and the certificate of analysis. All these documents can be found on our website, which is directly accessible via the QR barcode on the test kit. Just scan it with your smartphone. Thanks for watching this video. Feel free to subscribe to this channel now and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any upcoming videos. And if there are still open questions by now, please do not hesitate to contact us via phone or mail. I hope to see you soon on this channel.